if you updated your OBS software, or rather you open your OBS software and discover that the NDI plugin here, it's not currently working on your own OBS software, here is how you can permanently fix this problem on your own OBS software. Now if you take a look at the top of the screen here, you discover I'm using the latest version of OBS, and that is the OBS 30.0.2. I'm going to show you how you can fix this problem and have the NDI source working perfectly fine on your own OBS studio. Now before you go ahead and follow through with the guide I'm about to share with you, make sure your OBS is running on the OBS 30.0.2, and let's go ahead, let me show you how to fix this problem. And the first thing you're going to do is head over to your browser and visit this website. This is the OBS NewTek NDI integration plugin. Now you need to download and install this plugin on your own OBS. Now if you take a look at the screen, you'll see the minimum OBS studio is required for OBS 29. For you to be able to run this plugin, you need to be running the OBS 29. The big mistake that a lot of streamers make is when they update the OBS studio, they don't update the plugin that runs on the OBS studio. And when you don't update those plugins, they come with a lot of fixes. Whenever you update the OBS studio, always check if the plugin you use on the OBS studio has updates on them, and that is very, very important, because that will help to fix some of the issues or some of the challenges you're having on the OBS studio. Go over to download button here, click on it, and this new page is going to pop up, and that is it here. Now when you get to this one here, you're going to see this plugin now requires OBS 30.0.0. for you to be able to run this plugin on your own OBS, you need to install the OBS 30.0.2 or the OBS 30.0.0, and no, most of you are currently running the OBS latest version but have failed to update the plugin as well, which is very, very important. Always do that on your own OBS studio. Now scroll down till you see test assets here. You have the first one, which is for Mac, the second one, and the third one is for Windows, which is the one we are going to install. If you take a look by the side here, you're going to see this update was made on November 14th 2023. Now go ahead and click on the Windows one here as the installer and download it on your own PC. Remember, I've dropped the link in the description of this video, so go ahead and check it out. Once you've already downloaded the plugin, go ahead and open your file explorer, and that is it here, the OBS 4.13.0. right click on it, you could either open or run as administrator, whichever one you do is perfectly fine. Now click on the open here and follow the prompt to install the plugin on your own PC. Make sure that the OBS software is not running while you're installing this plugin, and once you're done, open your OBS studio, and that will fix this NDI source issue here that you're currently facing on the OBS software, and you should see this pop up on the screen. Now in case you didn't see it, restart your PC and you should be able to see this working perfectly fine on your own OBS studio. Thank you very much, and remember to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel if you haven't, and see you on the next one. In case the first method I shared did not work for you, here is the second method on how you can be able to fix the NDI issue on your own OBS software. And remember, I've also tested out these two methods on different PCs, and they both work perfectly fine. Should in case the first one did not work, and that is why I'm also including the second method in the course of this video. And I urge you to watch from beginning to the end so you will understand all the steps, because the second method is a bit tricky to be able to follow all the process and understand it step by step. Go ahead and open your web browser, open this web page, and remember I also included the link in the description of this particular video, and that is the OBS NewTek NDI integration plugin. And once you're on this web page, go over to download here, click on the go to download button, a new web page is going to open, and that is the OBS NDI 4.13.0. we are not going to download the 4.13.0, we are going to download other versions, and I will show you how to manually install it on your own PC as well. Now go over to the releases here at the top of the screen and click on it before the 4.13.0, where my mouse is, click on this and be able to see other versions that have also been released as well. And on the releases here, you're going to see the 4.13.1, which is the latest one. So scroll down till you see 4.11.1, and that is the one we are going to download. We'll just scroll down till you see this is 4.12.0, 4.11.1, and this is the one we are going to be making use of. Scroll down till you see asset. Click on the asset. On the asset here, you're going to see the list of all the files. Now we're not going to download the installer, and that is this one here with the OBS NDI 4.11.1 Windows installer. I'm going to download the zip file and not the installer. Click on the zip file here and it will download this on your own PC. Our file has successfully downloaded. Let's go ahead and open the folder. This is the file here, and that's the OBS NDI. Right click on it and then just unzip it. Okay, comes with zip. So you, if you have WinRAR or WinZip, you can just unzip or extract the file. And that's what we're going to do. Once you've extracted the file, let's go ahead and open it. And that is it here on the screen. On the folder, you're going to see the data folder and also the OBS plugin folder. Go over to your local disk. Double click on that to open your local disk. And once that is up already, the next thing you're going to do is go over to the program file on your local disk. The program file, not the program file x86, just the program files alone. Double click on that to open. And then over here, look for OBS Studio. And that is it here on the screen. This is it here. OBS Studio. Open the OBS Studio and you're going to see two folders here, the data and also the OBS plugins. See, this is the two folders that we saw on the OBS NDI 4.11.1 that we just extracted. Open the OBS 4.11.1 folder that we just extracted the file, and that is it here. You have the data and also the OBS plugin. Click on the OBS plugin, right click, and copy the file. Just copy the OBS plugin folder here, copy that, and go over to your program file, and that is it here. Right click on this place, and then let's paste the file. Paste, click on this. See, it's asking us to replace the existing one with the one we've copied from the OBS 4.11.1. Don't worry, just replace. It's not going to damage any of the file you already have on the folder inside the program file. It's just going to replace and add this new file on the folder that you have here already. All right, so just click on replace this. Do this for all the current items. Once you've already pasted this, the next thing that you're going to do, go back to the OBS 4.11.1 folder, click on the data folder, right click, and copy the data folder here. Then go over to the program file where you have the OBS Studio, right click, and paste it here also as well. Just paste these two folders inside the program file of the OBS Studio, okay? So just paste this as well. Admin permission also pasted as well. See, do this for all the file. And then here we have also pasted the data file on the program files, which is on our local disk. And once you've already done this, the next thing you're going to do is just for you to restart your PC, and you should be able to see the OBS plugin showing on your screen. Just restart your PC, go over to your sources, click on the add button here, and you should be able to see this NDI source here showing on your screen. And this is the second method on how to fix the NDI source on your own OBS software.